Hey y'all, and welcome back to the Pantry home. In today's video, I am going to be showing y'all some cleaning motivation as well as finishing up that small pantry makeover, and I'm super excited to share with y'all the results and how it looks. So stay tuned until the end of this video to see how I redo our small pantry. In last week's video, I showed y'all kind of organizing and starting to like clean it out and just trying to figure out kind of where I want things to go and all that. But y'all, once you see how it looks in today's video, it just looks so much better. So if you also have a small pantry, this video will be perfect for you in hopes of inspiring you to not only get it organized and make it look clean, but the way that I have remade it made it look a lot bigger than what it actually is. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you are new here, my name is Lakin and I'm so happy that you are here. So go ahead and hit that red subscribe button down below so you don't miss any future uploads from me, as well as give this video a big thumbs up, and let's go ahead and continue on and get started. So I'm just starting here in the master bedroom, and as y'all saw, it was a complete disaster. This was coming out of the weekend, and I really, you know, sometimes clean houses, sometimes don't clean house on the weekends. So this was on a Monday, so the sheets had to be changed, and the room was honestly just like looked like it was exploding. So I also just wanted to give the floors a quick vacuum after cleaning things up. And then I was in desperate need of cleaning our bathroom. You guys, I don't even know how long it's been since I've cleaned the shower. And so here's one of the things that I do not like to clean in my house. Cleaning the shower is my least favorite thing to clean of all things. And I don't know why. Why I don't like cleaning it, because when I clean it, it just makes me so happy and I feel so much better about it. Y'all, I try to clean it once a week, but I think it's probably been a month since I've cleaned it until this video. So that was an issue, and I totally wish I would have shot close-ups of how nasty the shower looked. And if I wasn't like on a time schedule on this particular day, I would have definitely have showed you guys close-ups, because it was horrendous. Because when I say that it's probably been 3 weeks to a month since I've touched the shower, I'm not even kidding. Like, it was so nasty. So for cleaning it, because it was such a disaster, I used an all-purpose cleaner, and then I also sprayed some scrubbing bubbles around the perimeter of the shower, and then I also laid down Comet, the bleach powder, as well. So I mixed all of those together, and then I took my stainless steel scrub like round, and then a brush as well, and it made the process so much easier. It just like got everything completely up and clean, like no time whatsoever. I rinsed all that down and then used my squeegee to just kind of help dry up the shower some. So those three things worked amazing. My shower was so clean, looked so good, smelled so good, and it really wasn't even like really laborious work when I mixed all those together. So totally recommend that combo, an all-purpose cleaner, Comet, and some scrubbing bubbles, and you're good to go. And the smell isn't too strong, like as far as the chemicals go, so it didn't really bother me. And yeah, so that worked really good. If you have tile showers, then you know how hard it is to keep your grout clean. Again, if you keep them cleaned like weekly, so you clean them once a week, it's not as bad. But if you get into like a little, you know, place where you're like me and you didn't clean it for a month, then go ahead, use those three things together, and I promise it will be great and your shower will be clean. But just try not to let it happen again, you know, because that's what I'm trying not to do. But it did clean up really nicely, and I'm really happy about that. But so that's kind of just what I'm doing here. And as you see, I got the squeegee out now. And then after that, I'm just going to pick up around the house, and then I'm going to move to the kitchen and do a few things in there, and then we will get onto that pantry makeover. But I want to know how everyone is doing today. I know that it is the weekend and I have no idea what we are doing this weekend or what our plans are. Next weekend we have some plans, but this weekend I think it's going to be more low-key because every Saturday in May I have something going on. I have weddings, I have to do a bridal makeup session for a wedding. I have my friend's wedding thing. She's getting married, and so we are going to be traveling like 2.5 hours away to that. And then I have like church events, and then just like friends, like get-togethers and stuff. So every weekend in May is booked. Like, it is going to be a very busy month. So I'm just kind of settling down this weekend, relaxing, staying at home. Gonna try to get some things done and film for you guys, and then I'm just like gonna buckle down and buckle up. But I do have some exciting news to share, but I think I'm going to share that in a later video, not in this one. But I have some exciting news and I'm really happy. The Lord is tremendously blessing my husband and I here recently, and we are very excited about where things are going and how life is taking us right now. But I do have some exciting news coming. I'm not really going to say much right now, but we are just very thankful and blessed for everything. I don't really know what else to say. I'm like smiling while saying all this to you guys because it's just a blessing, honestly, for us, for what's kind of happening right now. So so if you have any prayer requests, y'all, a big truck just went by. If that was in the video, if this voiceover had that, I am so sorry, but you never know where I live. Like, there's always trucks. That's this kind of area for you. But anywho, anybody has any prayer requests, please feel free to leave them down below, or just say a prayer for me, or whatever you need right now in this time and day, because I know sometimes it can be really hard and I don't want anyone to ever feel alone, because I know sometimes I feel alone sometimes, even though you're not. You do sometimes, and you kind of need that extra support and extra friends. So if you have any prayer requests and you need some prayer, then don't ever hesitate to leave this below or just message me about them, because I would love to pray for you and be your friend and try to help you out through a hard time if you're having one. But that is about all I have for you guys right now. So let's just go ahead and continue watching me clean this house up. And I hope you find some motivation to clean with me or redo your pantry as well. Alright, so now I'm just in the kitchen cleaning up a little bit here, and I'm not really going to clean up much because I am about to cook supper and everything, so I'm just going to save the dishes for after supper. But I do want to go ahead and roll the clips of this pantry makeover, because I filmed this on a separate day and the footage just wasn't long enough to make it into one separate video. So I just wanted to show you guys in this video and just add it in. So as you see, the outfit is completely different. On the day that I did do the pantry makeover, it was really cold here in North Carolina. And then as y'all saw when, like, real time when I was filming this actual video, like cleaning and everything, it was really hot that day. So If you live in North Carolina, you know how the weather is here. You never know what to expect. One day it's cold and one day it's hot. So far, it's been hot all week pretty much. It's been really, really nice, but it has been very, very warm. And I love it. I think it's beautiful, but I was very tempted to turn on the air condition, not even gonna lie. But as you see, this pantry is really, really small, and because it is this wood color, it makes it, it's all an illusion when you are like redoing things, so it makes it look smaller than what it actually is. So I am gonna be painting it white, which is gonna brighten it up and make it look bigger, as like when you have a room and you paint it white, it always makes a room just look bigger because it brightens everything up, and it's kind of like a reflective thing as well. So I'm just gonna take everything out of it, as you guys saw, and I'm gonna wipe it down really good, and then I'm just using a white Valspar. It's the perfect white paint, is what it's called, and it's in a semi-gloss, which is just easy to clean. And I'm just gonna start by edging out all of my trim in here with a trim brush, and then I'm just gonna take a small roller brush and roll the whole thing. I did just kind of do clips and pieces of this video instead of boring you guys and showing you like the whole entire process, because this probably took 2 to 3 hours to do, I think. And then for the shelves, you guys will see that I am going to be covering those in the adhesive, like almost kind of like wallpaper stuff, so it's like an adhesive with like a design on it. And I got that at Dollar General, and I think it was only like $1 or $2 a roll. It was super duper cheap, and I love the design, and it's the gray color and everything, and it just looks so pretty. I love it. Also, the bins with the pantry items in them. So the plastic bins came from Target, and the wired basket bins came from Dollar General as well, and those were $5 a piece, I'm pretty sure. All of the jars that are in the pantry also came from Dollar General, and those ranged from like $2 to $5, I'm pretty sure. So I just wanted to add that in there. But this is what it looks like, completely remodeled. And if you guys wanna see some before and after pictures, you can head over to my Instagram, which is at lakin.pendry, and you can see some up close, like before and after rolls as well. I always like to show before and after pictures of any projects that I do. But now I'm just gonna go ahead and start dinner and just kinda prep for that. And that's all that I have for you guys today. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, if you did, make sure you hit that red subscribe button if you are new here. And also don't forget to hit that like button. I would love for you guys to leave any video recommendations that you may have for me that you would like to see here at the Pantry home. I'm always looking for new ideas or new projects to do, but I hope you all have a wonderful day and a wonderful blessed weekend, and I will see you guys in the next video. So hope you all have a wonderful day. Bye, y'all.